And let me say to all, and thanks for the invitation. I mean that the topic is rather interesting for a trade unionist. So that I will try to put my two cents worth of our concept and how we see it, because we come from a position where the question of the labor business and government must collectively work together to ensure that we have the correct balance to make the economy grow. And when I say the economy, I'm talking from a Caribbean perspective too. But having said that, I think that what the COVID-19 would have exposed was the vulnerability of our economies and the less advantaged people in our society, or should I say disadvantaged people. And therefore, as we move forward and we talk about the new normals, the question is what do we put in place from where we sit to ensure that these disadvantaged communities, children and people, single mothers, are really taken care of so that they will be part of what I will call the new development trusts. Because we believe that if you leave anybody outside, we will create some serious social issues. And there's a saying in the trade union movement, a blow to one is a blow to all, and an injustice to one is an injustice to all. So the question from where we sit is, what do we understand about this economy? What has been exposed? Because a lot of things that we thought was the gospel or the given economic truth would have fallen by the wayside. And therefore, does COVID-19 force us to think in a new paradigm, to think a new way? As I say, does it force us to think about the we economics as opposed to the I economics? And I say that against the backdrop, that if we do not understand by now that workers who we thought wasn't essential or critical or frontline workers would have been able to come to the fore as against those what we traditionally used to think was the cream of the hierarchical system as we know it in terms of employment. And how do we then merge that reality for the benefit of all? I think that is a question that we have to debate. I think that is a question that we have to understand. That is a question that we must analyze, because the reality is that the market forces, as we have been told by the Ricardos and the Chicago institutions, etc., is not really a reality. What has come out is that if you don't have consumer power, and consumer power in our estimation from the trade union perspective is the ability to buy the goods and services, well, then your economy is going to fall by the wayside. So that when we speak about opening up, let us open up, and there is not this understanding that goods and services must be purchased, goods and services must be produced for an economy to turn around, well, then we are missing the bus from where we sit. And I think that the conversation has to be around those realities. And one fundamental issue I think that we must pay attention to is the interconnectedness of the economic global market. All right, so that who believe that they were big and who believe that they were strong, look at what is happening. Look at the economies who have been able to better survive this pandemic as opposed to the other major economies who are still stuttering in the context of what is happening. And the conversation must be along those lines for us to understand the realities, because we can talk about, you know, the new normal, we could talk about online shopping, we can talk about all those things. I cannot shop unless I have the ability to buy the goods and services. And if there is no ability to buy the goods and services, well, then there is no reinvestment. And if there is no reinvestment within your business, how do your business go? So that triangle that I'm talking about is so interconnected. And therefore, the conversation from where we sit has to and must be around those fundamental issues. Finally, the issue of health and safety, all right, has to be critical to whatever conversation that we are having as a people, because we now have to look at health and safety. We have to look at the human resource capacity and ability as fundamental to your economy. We cannot exclude those realities and believe then that the issue of money has to be paramount, first and foremost, and foremost rather. So that I will want to end by making those observations that we would have made from a trade union perspective. And we are now understanding the wisdom of the tripartite approach, because no entity or no separate constituency can resolve any of these issues separately. There must be this collective approach, there must be this social dialogue, and there must be a meeting of minds, an exchanging of ideas, and the question of respect in the context of my right to disagree with you. Thank you.